Cole Porter left a legacy as one of the nation's finest composers and songwriters. He was born in Indiana 125 years ago this month. To celebrate, Jeffrey Brown once again joined composer and musicologist Rob Kapilow at Signature Theater in Arlington, Virginia. It's the latest in our occasional series on what makes great music great.
Rob Kapilow, welcome back.
So great to be here.
Cole Porter this time, okay?
Cole Porter.
So you've picked one of his most famous songs, You're the Top.
You're the top. You're the Colosseum. Who could forget that?
You're the Colosseum. It shows he's a man known for the sophistication of his language, right? This sort of highbrow, but lowbrow as well.
Right.
And for the songs, because he did both.
He did both, but the truth is, though he's really famous for these incredibly witty, sophisticated lyrics with these erudite rhymes and imagery, It's actually the way they combine with the music that makes it so unforgettable. And people often underestimate how crucial the music is to those famous
lyrics.
So
how does it work in this
So song? Let's take the most famous one, You're the Top, the opening one. Now, it seems like who could possibly ruin that great lyric? I mean, it's got an exclamation mark, You're the Top, but let me ruin it for you. Okay, he could have written this. You're the top. Now, I mean, the lyric stays the same. My version simply leapt one octave to the same notes. He leaps one note higher to this great dissonance, but then a full octave higher, this huge leap. It's a leap up to the top. Uh-huh. And in a way, that leap, all the energy of the leap and the dissonance, already tells us what You're the Top is about before we've heard a single note from the voice.
You're the top. You're the Colosseum. You're the top. You're the Louvre Museum.
This song, it's not a story, right?
Right.
Not much happens. It's just him over and over again, you're the top in different language, but you're saying it's also in different music.
It's the music that makes the language so witty. I mean, just that difference. I mean, it could have been after this leap, all even notes, you're the top. Uh-huh. But instead of square on the beat, you're the top, it's syncopated. Not just the top, you're the top, but even you're the top. And it's that swingy rhythm that tells us what you're the top feels like. Mm-hmm. So instead of a boring version, you're the top, it's the music that makes it, you're the top. Mm-hmm. That's what makes it so fantastic.
And he was one of these composers who did both the music and lyrics.
He did do both the music and lyrics, and that makes people tend to think that somehow it really matters which comes first. It's the most frequently asked question of all songwriters, which comes first, the music and the lyrics.
Of course.
It makes no difference. In a great song...
No difference.
No difference whatsoever. In a great song, once words and music combine, they become a new, completely interdependent element. Mm-hmm. Words cease to have a purely literary meaning, and music ceases to have a purely musical meaning. Though it's true, these are enormously sophisticated lyrics. Without the music, they would never work. And the last line of this first verse is a perfect example. I mean, it's everything that people think of when they think of Cole Porter. You've got these three great images. So what are you? You're a Bendel bonnet. That means a bonnet from that upper class women's store, Bendel's. You're a Bendel bonnet and a Shakespeare sonnet. First thing that makes it great is this syncopation. He goes, you're a Bendel bonnet. The same thing for Shakespeare sonnet.
You're a Bendel bonnet, a Shakespeare sonnet.
You're Mickey Mouse.
So what do we finish with? You're Mickey Mouse. Incredibly lowbrow, popular in the 30s, introduced in 1928. And it's that combination of the syncopation and the music underneath that makes these witty, sophisticated lyrics unforgettable. You're a Bendel bonnet, a Shakespeare sonnet. You're Mickey Mouse. And then the piano almost speaks to you. Yes, you're Mickey Mouse. And we're back for another round of great Porter.
This goes to what we often talk about, what makes a great song.
Yeah, what makes a great song is not the great words and is not the great music. It's the combination of the two. Words mean nothing by themselves. Music means nothing by themselves. The two reinforce themselves and become a new unit that cannot be understood separately. And in Porter's case, he wrote both, and they're both great.
Cole Porter, Rob Kapilow, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.